गुड मॉर्निंग, एम ऑडिबल?
यस सर।
Okay, good morning. Is the screen visible to all?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I hope everyone has watched the videos on the remaining portion of the fourth unit. Yesterday during the lecture itself, I had shared the links of four videos, okay, which in total explained the remaining three points which were left in the fourth unit, okay. And I had told you to watch the videos yesterday and come prepared in order to solve the MCQs today. So has everyone done that?
Yes, sir.
Remaining? Okay. So let us solve the numericals now. Let us solve the MCQs now. These MCQs you will find it out on page number. Okay, one second, I'll just show you. You can see here the PDF of the textbook of fluid mechanics and hydraulic machines. Okay, is a textbook that I have already shared with you on our group in the last semester itself. Okay, now in that for the lesson of impact of free jets. Okay, now this textbook is divided into two parts. First is the fluid mechanics and second is the hydraulic machines. So in the second part, that is the hydraulic machinery part, chapter 1 is impact of jets. Okay, and in that chapter you have to open the page number 49. Okay, and there you will find out this MCQs. So let us solve these MCQs. Okay, so let us first see question number one. The force exerted by a jet of water on a stationary vertical plate in the direction of the jet is given by. Yes. What will be the answer? So a stationary vertical plate is such, okay, it is a plate, flat plate which is stationary, okay, that means it is fixed, that means it will not be able to move, and as it is vertical, the jet will strike on it in a perpendicular manner, and after the jet strikes, okay, the force will be mass per second, that is rho av. Rho av into initial velocity with which the jet strikes minus the final velocity, that is zero. So the correct answer here is option B, that is the force exerted by jet of water on stationary vertical plate in the direction of the jet is given by rho av square. Okay. Next, the force exerted by the jet of water on a moving vertical plate in the direction of motion of plate is given by. Now, can you answer this second question? Please answer this second question. The force exerted by the jet of water on a moving vertical plate. It is a vertical flat plate which is moving.
Option C.
Option C.
The correct answer is option C. Okay. Rho A into V minus U whole bracket square. So instead of just V square, it will be V minus U. Why? Because in the first question, the jet was stationary. Sorry, the plate was stationary. So the jet struck the plate with absolute velocity V. But when the jet was moving in the second question, when the plate was moving in the second question, the jet struck the plate not with an absolute velocity V, but with a relative velocity V minus U. Okay, why? Because the plate is moving. Next, when a steady jet impinges on a fixed inclined surface, what happens? The flow is divided into parts proportional to the angle of inclination of the surface. Option A. Option B. No force is exerted by the jet on the vane. C. The momentum component is unchanged parallel to the surface. And D. None of the above. So what is the correct answer? When a steady jet impinges or strikes on a fixed inclined surface. So there is this inclined surface, okay, which is fixed. Okay. So after the jet strikes the fixed inclined surface, what is going to happen? Is the flow going to get divided into parts proportional to the angle of inclination of the surface? Or is there going to be no force which is going to be exerted by the jet on the vane? Yes, what is the correct answer?
Option B.
Yes. ऑप्शन
बी सर।
ए आई कैन नॉट हियर यू प्रॉपरली, स्पीक अ लिटिल लाउडर।
ऑप्शन बी सर।
बी
ऑप्शन ए ए नर सर।
व्हाई?
वेलोसिटी वेलोसिटी डायवर्ट होती सर, म्हणजे प्लेटला स्ट्राइक होऊन।
यस एंड सो इट गेट्स डिवाइडेड इनटू पार्ट्स प्रोपोर्शनल टू द एंगल ऑफ इंक्लिनेशन ऑफ द सरफेस, दैट इज द करेक्ट आंसर। राइट नाउ वन ऑफ यू सेड ऑप्शन बी। नाउ व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम विथ ऑप्शन बी इज no force is exerted by the jet on the wind, but there is force exerted by the jet of water on the plate. Okay, ani apan already te find out kelela hai. You can see impact of jet on a stationary flat inclined plate, there's a force cha formula hai. You might be confusing it with work done. For stationary plate, there is no work done. Okay, that is correct. The work done is zero. But still, there is a force which is exerted by the jet on the wind. Okay. Now, question number four. For maximum efficiency of a series of curved vanes, the speed is... So, for in order to obtain the maximum efficiency for a series of curved plates, okay. Now, this is the part of lecture number 10 of the YouTube video that I have sent you. Okay. Impact of jet on a series of curved plates. Okay. So, anyone remembers it? Okay, for a series of curved vanes, work done per second is rho A into V into bracket V minus U into bracket 1 plus cos theta into U. Now, this work done per second will be our output. Okay, then what will be the input? Input will be the kinetic energy which has been released by the action of the jet. So it will be half mv square. So divide for if in order to obtain efficiency, we divide output upon input. Output is, as you know, it is work done per second. Input is kinetic energy, that is half mv square. Now half into m will be nothing but rho a into v. Okay, and v will be V square will be nothing but the absolute velocity of the jet, that is V. So let us solve it. So one second, there is a problem with the mic. There is problem with the mouse. Just. Just wait for 2 minutes. Okay. Is the screen visible now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, impact of jet on series of curved vanes. अपन ते जी efficiency find out करायची आहे. We have to find out its efficiency. Eta. So what is the output? Rho A V into V minus U into 1 plus cos theta into U. Now what will be the input? Half mv square, where m is rho A V into V square. So here rho AV will get cut. Okay, 1V. Sorry, no. It will be V minus U into bracket 1 plus cos theta into U upon half V square. Okay. Then what we have to do in order to find out maximum efficiency? Okay. What should be maximum? The velocity of the jet should be maximum in order to obtain maximum efficiency. So we will differentiate with the help of V. Okay, differentiate V in the direction of x. So dv upon dx will integrate. Sorry, differentiate. And then we'll find out the answer. Now this will take some time. So what we are going to do? We are going to come back to this question. We'll go to the next question. Now, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Are the questions visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now question number one, force exerted by a jet on a stationary plate happens in how many cases? Can anybody tell? How many cases are there for stationary plate? Force exerted by jet on stationary plate?
Three cases.
Okay, one is the case of flat vertical plate, second is the case of flat inclined plate, and third is the case of curved plate. These are the three cases. Then, how force exerted by the jet on a moving plate happens in how many cases? तर मूविंग प्लेट मध्ये किती केसेस मध्ये होतात मूविंग प्लेट मध्ये किती केसेस होतात फोर्स एक्झर्टेड बाय जेट चे येस
थ्री
केसेस ओके सो फॉर बोथ द स्टेशनरी प्लेट And for the moving plate, there are three cases for the force exerted by the jet. Next, in a stationary vertical plate, question number three, the jet after striking the plate will move in opposite direction along the plate, perpendicular to the plate or parallel to the plate. Yes. What is the correct answer here?
Along the plate.
The correct answer is along plate, option D. Okay. Next, question number four. At what angle does the jet deflect after striking a stationary vertical plate? Yes. At what angle is the jet going to deflect after striking the stationary vertical plate?
90 degree.
It is going to be deflected at 90 degree. Okay. Then the velocity component after striking the surface will be for a stationary plate, the velocity component after striking the surface or the plate. What will be the value of velocity?
Zero.
Yes. Which among the following is the formula for force when it strikes the plate?
Rho AV square.
Yes. Others?
Option A.
ऑप्शन बी येते का ओके सो द करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन ए रो ए वी स्क्वेअर इफ यू सी द ऑप्शन डी ओके इट मेक्स नो सेन्स मास इंटू एरिया इंटू एनर्जी और वॉट एवर इट इज दिस मेक्स नो सेन्स Then if you see option B, okay, rho AV, you just have here that is mass per second. Now, if you multiply it by V, then this becomes the formula for force, which is the option A. Okay, my mouse is little bit wobbly today, so please bear with me. Next. To derive rho AV square, we take final velocity minus the initial velocity, true or false?
False.
The others?
सर वी टेक इनिशियल वेलोसिटी माइनस फाइनल वेलोसिटी.
करेक्ट. What we take is initial velocity in the direction of the jet minus final velocity. So the correct answer here is false. Next, the mass of water per second striking the plate is
rho AV.
Option B. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Next. Which among the following is the formula for force when it acts along the direction of flow? Yes, tell me.
Option A.
Option A. Rho AV square sine theta. Okay. In order to check it, you have to just read the notes again that I already so sent you. Next. Which among the following is the formula for force when it acts perpendicular to the direction of the flow? What is the formula? So for that, you have to see the case of impact of jet on stationary inclined plate. First,
option A.
Option A. So in that, what we had done was we had found out the first. We had found out normal force Fn, right? Then after that, we had found out two components of normal force Fn. The first component in the direction of the flow was the Fx component. There's a formula, kutla hota? Varcha, rho av square sine square theta. Second component kutla hota? In the vertical direction. Or the direction perpendicular to the flow. And there's a rho a v square sine theta cos theta. Now, this question is a little bit wrong. A jet strikes a curved plate at its. Okay, it can also strike at one of the sides. It can also strike at the center. Okay, so this question here probably is wrong. Then we have here the question of hydraulic jumps. Next. Question number 14. A jet after striking a smooth plate comes out with a dash velocity. That means after striking a smooth plate, the jet will come out with increased velocity, decreased velocity, or the same velocity, or zero velocity. So what is the correct answer here?
Option C, same.
Same velocity. So if the plate is smooth, we will assume that there is no loss of energy. आणि जेवढी वेलॉसिटी स्ट्राइक व्हायच्या आधी आहे तेवढीच वेलॉसिटी आफ्टर स्ट्राइकिंग असणार आहे. नेक्स्ट, कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ वेलॉसिटी इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ जेट इज मायनस वी कॉस थीटा. True or false? Yes, true or false? Yes, anybody?
True.
Others? Now, for example, one second. Okay. Now this is an example of curved plate. Okay, when the jet strikes. Now, if you see the direction of the jet is going towards the right or the positive x direction. And minus v cos theta kuta asnar ahe negative x direction. नेगेटिव एक्स डायरेक्शन मध्ये. सो द आंसर टू द क्वेश्चन विल बी फॉल्स. कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ वेलोसिटी इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ जेट इज नॉट माइनस वी कॉस थीटा बिकॉज देन इट विल बी अपोजिट डायरेक्शन. ओके, नेक्स्ट. यस, क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. इन अ स्टेशनरी वर्टिकल प्लेट द जेट आफ्टर स्ट्राइकिंग द प्लेट विल मूव. द आंसर इज अलोंग द प्लेट. सो ऑलरेडी दिस क्वेश्चन हैज बीन टेकन. सो दिस क्वेश्चंस हैव ऑलरेडी बीन टेकन. Okay, so this question number 12 has not been taken still. Which among the following is the formula for relative velocity?
Option C.
V minus u, velocity of jet minus velocity of plate. Next. Component of velocity in the direction of the jet is minus v cos theta. What does theta indicate? The theta here indicates angle made by the jet at the outlet tip. Okay, so the correct answer here is B, the angle made by jet at the outlet tip. Now let us solve some more numericals that we are able to find. So the force exerted by a jet of water impinging normally on a plate due to the impact of jet moves in the direction of the jet with a velocity small v is. What will be the answer here? So, It is in the form of, the question is in the form of rho, or the answer is in the form of rho A. V minus U whole bracket square. Okay, so instead of rho, okay, what is given here is W, that is specific weight divided by acceleration due to gravity, which is nothing but density. Okay, so the correct answer here should be C, but in the correct answer here, in the solution here, they have given it as D, but they have not explained it. Okay, so this will not be the correct answer. This will be the correct answer. Next, let us see, because we are able to find very less questions on impact of jet. Let us see some more questions if they are available. Okay, most of the questions are on hydraulic machinery, that means pumps and turbines. Okay, so here is one question. The force exerted by a jet of water impinging normally on a plate. Okay, so this is the same question which I already solved. So as you can see, there are very less questions here. You can do one thing, you can go through the websites. I will be sending you the MCQs today. Okay. The problem was I have brought my own laptop to the college. There is some problem with the PC, so I could not open it and give you the MCQs. So what I'll do, I'll get it. I'll get it repaired, the PC of my cabin, and then I'll find out the MCQs, then I'll send it to you by 1 or 1:30, okay, maximum.
Okay, sir.
Yes. So that is why I had to depend upon these MCQs which are on online. There are very less MCQs on impact of jet online. Okay, and even in the examination, most of the questions on impact of jet will either be on the formula, okay, or either on efficiency. So just before the examination, just study the formulas. You should have the formulas with you, as well as the formulas for efficiency as well as work done. Okay. If you have that, if you remember those formulas, you will be easily able to solve any questions on the impact of jet. Now, how many of you have yet to watch the videos that I have uploaded yesterday? Or how many have watched it? Please raise your hand, those who have watched it. Roll number 67, 68, 34, 18, 4. Only 5 students have watched it. Roll number 18, 4, 5, 34, 68, 67. I think only 5-6 students have watched it. Sir, बाकीच्या लोकांना मला वाटते पास होण्याचा पूर्ण कॉन्फिडन्स आहे विदाउट अभ्यास करता बरोबर. Okay, so I will be sending you the MCQ list today itself, and today what I am going to do, I am going to send you the notes and the videos of the fifth unit, that is pumps and turbines. Okay, roll number 12 says we will watch it today definitely. Okay, I believe you, but today I am also going to send you the videos of fifth unit, all the videos. I'm going to share the link. So what are you going to do about that? Kalche pan lecture ani aajcha pan sagle milun ekdam load vadel tumcha varti. Okay, so I will be sending you the notes and videos of fifth unit immediately after the class gets over, and then tomorrow what we'll do, we'll discuss the MCQs on fifth unit as well as the remaining MCQs of fourth unit. आज आपले सगळे MCQs घेऊन झालेले नाहीत. एकदा माझा पीसी रिपेअर झाला की मी त्यातून मी MCQs ची लिस्ट काढतो. मी माझ्याकडे PDF आहे and I'll send it to you. Is there any question? Shall I end the lecture? Shall I end the lecture?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you can leave now. Thank you, everyone.